You know what I hate? Working out. It's the worst. If only I could reward myself with like a cheeseburger afterwards. Sound counterproductive? New research suggests maybe not. Hey Hungry Hippos, Julia here for DNews. A recent study from the University of Montana found that there was no difference in energy gain from eating fast food or from taking sports supplements. In the study published in the International Journal of Sport Nutrition and Exercise Science, 11 male cyclists cycled for 90 minutes, depleting their bodies of glycogen. Right after the ride, and then 2 hours later, the participants either ate fast food or took sports supplements. Then 4 hours after the first bit of exercise, they did a 12.4-mile time trial. The researchers found no difference in blood glucose and insulin response between fast food and supplements. But even more intriguing, there wasn't a difference in the athlete's performance in the time trial. This story sounds great! I mean, I could go on a mile run and then eat a greasy cheeseburger with some french fries and be healthy, right? Right? Yeah? Hold on, let's take a closer look at this. First of all, it was an incredibly small study with only 11 male cyclists as participants. Any study with a small sample size warrants some caution. But what about their results? This is really a story about glycogen, which is a type of carbohydrate found in a few different cell types like liver cells. But in this case, it's important that it makes up about 1 to 2% of your muscle mass. Your body uses glycogen easily during exercise. In fact, it's the first energy source muscles use to contract, especially during high-intensity exercise. Some intense athletes, like marathon runners, can deplete their body's store of glycogen during a workout. They hit the wall and experience extreme fatigue that makes it hard to even move. Thus, a lot of athletes carbo-load before a big race or a game. But restoring glycogen afterwards is super important too. By eating lots of carbs afterwards, the body's glycogen stores are replenished and can build bigger muscles with more glycogen storage capabilities for future exercise. So this is basically what the study focused on. It could mean that any high glycemic index foods would restore your glycogen levels, like pasta, pizza, bread, rice, pasta. Did I say pasta? I mean, I really, really like pasta. Another way of looking at the study is that sports nutrition supplements work just as well as fast food, which doesn't bode well for nutritional supplements. I mean, would you pay 60 bucks for a bottle of supplements over like a $5 value meal down the street? Well, you wouldn't be the only one. Over 150 million Americans take some form of supplement. But nutritional supplements have their own host of problems. The New York State Attorney General's office recently tested dietary supplements and found that many don't contain what they're supposed to. But what's actually in them is another story. One study published in JAMA International Medicine found that many supplements for weight loss and bodybuilding were recalled for containing banned substances that could cause serious health problems or death. And I mean, really, let's not say fast food is good for athletes. Fast food is still considered a leading cause of obesity. Most fast food meals are high in fats and sugar. While these are good for the body in small doses, too much of a good thing is bad, very bad. I mean, too much fast food increases your risk of heart disease and stroke. And the authors of the fast food study say that the hype is just that, hype. Moderation is key in anything. Don't go binge on a big burger and fries after every workout. Ugh, sad day. Would you give up your bodybuilding pills for a cheeseburger? Let's be real, we all would. Let us know down in the comments below. While you're at it, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here. We've got new episodes every day of the week.